Yo, what's up? Oh man, crazy weekend. A lot's going on. I just realized too that the last two episodes we said nothing about Prince at all.
Your
what?
I don't know. Cause Prince wore Nike heels.
I'm just saying, we talked about Game of Thrones, but we didn't mention Prince at all.
We did talk about Prince.
Did we?
Yeah.
I don't remember that conversation.
Yeah, we talked about Prince. It wasn't the past two weeks.
He was the first guy to have air bubbles in his heels.
We talked about Prince, dude.
I remember that. Maybe my memory
remember
is short.
I said when Juan had to take over the light-skinned delegation?
Ah, yeah. Oh, that was the short end of it then.
Okay. No, it was a whole conversation.
Oh, was it?
You're the first white person I even considered like.
Wow.
Get out of here.
Prince isn't white, though.
All right, so this is the Sneaker Box Podcast. I am the African Caesar.
You introduce everybody, bro. What are you?
I know. I was waiting. Was my drop at? All right.
All hail Caesar, Emperor of Rome, Monarch of the Roman Empire.
I'm just gonna eat my goldfish, bro.
World.
Yeah.
Hail Caesar! Hail Caesar! Hail Caesar!
All right. Then I got my right hand man, ironically sitting to my left, Juan Neal.
In a world, one man.
It's Juan.
And that's how KD landed into the Western Conference Finals. And we out here,
I forgot
you know what
that.
I'm saying? And I declare that we will win one game. We are going to win a game against Golden State. We out here.
That's why
all
I got
you
my,
haters.
That's why I got my Westbrook pants on today.
Right. And I've been uncomfortable ever since, bro. He got, wow. He got like five or six zippers on his jeans. It's like, what are you wearing?
I'm telling you right now, I wanted to be on another planet the other day when Thunder won. Because I just knew. At least you're not as bad as Guru, though. I will give you that.
Who? Guru?
Ooh. Ooh, wow.
Warriors, come out and play. Warriors, come out and play.
I should I bring it up now? Having trouble in paradise over there. Just thought about the other day when he posted that that long ass status about why LeBron deserved MVP.
Oh, and then he ended it with heart emojis. But anyways, man, let's get back to introducing these people.
Yeah. Still haven't found Trufe yet. Trufe is lost. Oh, there you go. All right, and we got Trufe. Wait for it.
His reputation is expanding faster than the universe.
Oh my God.
He once had an awkward moment just to see how it feels. He lives vicariously through himself. He is the most interesting man in the world.
That was worth the wait.
And that's how I went.
That was worth the wait. I am actually impressed. It gets better every week. Like, I'm actually looking for... But there's one thing I look forward to every show is now your drops. You went from no drops to by far having the best drops on the show.
I am the drop god.
You can't handle the truth.
Oh, you got two? What? All right.
Wait a minute.
And there goes. And then not last but not least, we have newcomer Kina. Or is it Kina Monet? Is it just Kina?
Yes, it's Kina Monet.
Kina Monet. We are having audio problems today.
Don't ever call me doll.
Whoa. Oh, okay, doll.
Why, good Lord.
Right. This is the Sneaker Box Podcast of Sneaker Bar Detroit, partnered with Crep Protect. What's the point of spending all that money on your shoes if you're not going to keep them clean long enough to get your money's worth? Practice safe stunting. Go to crepprotect.com and get your shoes some protection. Make sure to follow us on our social media. Follow us on Instagram at @thesneakerbox_podcast. Follow us on Twitter at @_sneaker_box. And on Facebook, simply at The Sneaker Box Podcast. And if you'd like to talk to us live on a podcast, you can call us every Monday between 11 and noon at 888-799-5267. Also, too, if you work in retail and you have any crazy sneaker stories, email us at tsb@sneakerbardetroit.com. All right. Sneaker Box top 10 releases.
A fucking 10.
Top 10 releases from the previous week. Number 10, we have the Reebok Bolton. White Chalk Navy. They brought back that retro. Definitely dope. I think Reebok's going to do what everybody else has been doing, just coming up with retros.
That's what they should do, bro, because yeah. their new designs.
Horrible. number nine, you have the Nike Kyrie 2 crossover.
Boys need a crossover to the garbage can.
Yeah, it was a lot going on.
Nah, it was cool. It was, you know what, just that strap. Like, it was subtle. If it was all over the shoe, I would agree.
I thought you liked straps. Go ahead.
Nike Excuse me while I whip this out.
No, put it back. Nike Air Penny 2 OG Home. That's number eight. Number seven, the Nike Air Presto Premium Granite. Yeah. Number six, we have the Adidas Original Fashion Week Pack. Came with some tubulars and I think a Stan Smith, I believe. Number five, the Undefeated Special Edition ASICS Gel Light 5 Disarray.
That was dope.
Yeah, definitely dope. Number four, we have another Nike Kyrie 2, the Nike Kyrie 2 GS Touch Factor. Number three, this was definitely, I don't think anybody's had this on their radar, but I suggest you do. The Nike Air Zoom 90 IT Black White. They are technically golf shoes, but they look like, I mean, they look like Air Maxes with ice bottoms. Ooh, Bautista's. We watching the video of my man getting his jaw rocked yesterday in the game.
Bautista, we'll get to that later
yeah,
on.
Yeah, that was ridiculous. Number two, the Air Jordan Retro 10 GS Vivid Pink. It wasn't as much chaos as the 12s that came out early this year, but
I think
did they sell out?
All the men were embarrassed.
I don't think anybody I didn't.
Yeah, I didn't see anybody wearing them.
I think all the guys smacked their lips, only people and then they stayed home. It was, we going
to
stay home.
Only people I seen wearing those went to the Jeezy concert.
Wow. Did you go?
No.
Oh. Oh, you know, go and get the drum. And number one, we have the crossover special edition Puma Displays Rose Red. Yes. That was the dopest shoe of the week. I don't know where you would have bought those from, but good luck finding those. Ugliest release of the week.
Super ugly.
You got the Nike Footscape Magista Flyknit Gorge Green.
Yeah, y'all did them.
And then I guess his ugly little sister is in the honorable mentions.
I thought that was the brother.
Brother, sister, that whole family ugly. Just
women know,
just,
grow facial hair too.
Yeah, that, yeah.
Kina?
Hopefully that family just dies off on its own without getting married.
My, that's lovely that is.
Nike Footscape Magista Flyknit Bright Crimson. I don't think there's a colorway that can make that shoe look good.
No.
Maybe invisible.
Probably clear.
Yeah.
get it in that Timberlake color.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
All right, let's pay some bills real quick.
Crep Attack. I put that shit on.
Okay.
Wrong. If you want to make sure your shoes look just as fresh as when they came out the box, practice safe stunting and go to crepprotect.com and get your shoes some protection.
That was a bill and a half.
Yeah. Two bills of $1, I guess. One stone, $1.
One fell swoop.
man, okay. A college professor is teaching the first ever English course about sneaker culture. An article written by Riley Jones for Complex.
Don't call me Curry.
A professor at Charlotte, North Carolina's Johnson C. Smith University is connecting the dots between sneaker culture and college English and capturing students' attention with his English 296 class. The course is taught by Jermaine King, a professor, author, and self-professed sneakerhead.
That's Jimmy King's cousin, right?
Yep. If your last name is King, you're all related. Martin Luther King.
No, I'm cool with that.
BB King.
BB King. Yeah, definitely.
He's a self-professed sneakerhead who says he could go a few years without wearing the same pair twice. Ooh! Jermaine penned the book Soul Food, Digestible Sneaker Culture back in 2008. And now he's using his findings to teach students lessons that reach far beyond English. The course also touches on elements of sociology, economics, and history, all through the lens of sneaker culture. It's worth noting that this isn't actually the first college course about sneakers. In 2008, two Carnegie Mellon alumni started a course known as Sneakerology 101. But it is the first English class to use sneaker culture as a guideline. Yeah, that's real cool. So if you are at that school and you did not know that class existed, well, now you know.
There go a free credit.
Exactly. Michael Jordan is taking a stand against North Carolina's anti-LGBT law.
Look at him set it up for something, bro.
He's not gonna move the Hornets out of there, though.
No, not at all.
I mean, that'd be too much.
Baby steps. Yeah. An article written by Riley Jones for Complex.
Don't you dare call me Curry.
You know, I love how she came into that. Her dad won MVP.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And she came
in. I got that as a gift.
That is hilarious.
Gotta watch these.
She's gonna have her own reality show when she gets older. Watch.
Yeah, probably.
Michael Jordan is the latest celebrity to speak out against North Carolina's controversial HB2 law, which many have called discriminatory against the LGBT community. MJ issued a statement to the Charlotte Observer saying that the Hornets are opposed to discrimination in any form and have always sought to provide an inclusive environment. As has been the case since the building opened, we will continue to ensure that all fans, players, and employees feel welcome at work or attending NBA games and events at Time Warner Cable Arena.
Trying to keep that All-Star game.
Yeah. That arena sounds a lot better than Little Caesars Arena. One of the HB2 laws most outspoken critics has... one of the HB2 laws most outspoken critics has been the NBA, which is currently slated to hold next year's All-Star Weekend in Charlotte. Commissioner Adam Silver has gone on the record saying the bill is problematic for the league and could cause 2017's All-Star event to change locations altogether.
Maho, what are some of any of the laws we should really
we should do that. But I will say this. I'm all for gay rights. I'm all for it. Living your life however you see fit. It is not up to me to judge you. Having said that, I do feel like in the pursuit of equality, people have voluntarily ignore the other parts of this issue. Like, I just feel like this law is too ambiguous, and knowing who goes to what bathroom is too subjective. And I think there is some unintended consequences that may come out of this law. I just feel like people are acting like people won't take advantage of this law to do things. Now, yes, transgender people have been using the bathrooms and whatnot, but now that people know, that kind of opens up a whole new door, and I think it opens up a Pandora's box of a lot of things. So while I'm kind of in the middle, because once again, like, I want to be fair to other people,
but I mean, gay people and whatnot. If a transgender woman goes into a women's bathroom, we all know 1,000% that transgender woman isn't looking at other women.
I'm not worried about the transgender woman. I'm worried about the people that could possibly take advantage of this law to do other stuff.
Like what?
Like, for example, my sister, she's a psychologist. Anyway, she works at a high school here in the area. And she was saying that here, there's a law here already to that effect, where, like, if somebody associates with a certain gender, you can't question. You just got to, like, basically cater to that. And she said that before this law even came out, you already had people going back and forth. You know, with teenagers, teenagers do what teenagers do.
Fantastic.
Yeah, and so she was saying you had boys, so you already had that. Like, not to say that anything happened or whatnot. And I'm not saying transgender people are just these predators looking to prey on you while you're taking a shit. Right. I'm just saying that just like we had people taking advantage of tax laws, we got people taking advantage of stand your ground laws, there are going to be people that take advantage of this law, and we got to be mindful of it. That's all I'm saying. And when people say that they have a little bit of issue with it, I don't think it necessarily comes from a bigoted place. I just think that we've gotten to the point where conversations are so PC that you aren't able to have a real conversation in context. And so that's all I'm saying. There's two sides to the issue.
Everybody kind of gets overly offended.
Yeah, very much so. And I think you can be constructively critical of this law without being a bigot. That's all I'm saying. Like, not to say bigots aren't going to find a reason to be against this law, but I can see why a woman would have an issue,
with a transgender woman using.
Well, because if I felt like it, I could be like, I feel like being a woman today, and then I roll up in there. I can see why a woman would have an issue with that.
It's like me going to the bathroom and then Caesar says, "Oh,
I'm transgender.
I'm just gonna go inside the bathroom.
I think people are reading too deep into that. But if a transgender woman, a man that has transitioned into a woman, a man that transitioned to a woman, goes into the male bathroom because of the law, that could cause more problem for that person than them being able to go into the women's bathroom. And, like, of course, you can notice that certain people who have transitioned, you can't tell that they used to be a man, but there are a lot where you can't tell that they used to be a man. And if you're a woman and you got to take a shit or you got to pee, you're not really caring about if this person is a man or a woman. You exactly. need if you need to take a shit, you need to mind your business, right. go take that shit, and you need to let that transgender woman go ahead and use the bathroom.
No, I agree with you.
There's
That's
no
what I'm
problem
saying.
With that.
And the same right, thing, the same thing with the man. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, instead of y'all, because I mean, what you doing looking in the, at the other stall anyway?
I'm not saying that, but if I was to walk into a woman's bathroom, people gonna notice.
But bro, like, you're thinking too deep into it. No, you're, like, I'm thinking that, like, I'm a dude. With a jersey on and some jeans, all of a sudden he's just going to be dumb and say, I want to be a woman and walk in there.
But you already have that.
You already know he's going to get arrested. He's going to get flicked, and he's going to become a sexual predator, and he's going to be sitting right next to Pee Wee Herman.
Right. I think we agree on that part. I'm just saying, but there's a lot can happen between.
Not everyone actually shows it. Like,
exactly.
I can like the same sex and still dress like a woman. You know, like vice versa for a man. He can... like the same sex and then still dress like a man, but it's like...
Like, allegedly, Caitlyn Jenner still likes women, but she's dressed like a woman.
I'm saying that would be saying, like, a lesbian couldn't go to a woman's bathroom because she's going to look at women.
No, I agree. Well, now we... Yeah, no, that's another element to it. So, all I'm saying is that you can't outright dismiss another person's point of view and just outright call them a bigot without... I just feel like the conversation... isn't a real honest conversation.
People
I just think
need to just live. Man.
I think
just,
I agree. To have, just people. I think we pick back up on this next week. You get some clarity.
Yeah, we'll try to get some specific
because
laws.
I feel like, but nobody's gonna agree.
Don't tell, mind your own business and live.
The few things I have seen, it does seem a little ambiguous. But in any event,
I'm tired of using these words, bro. If you use one more word I can't spell, bro, I'm going to smack you with this pen.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
I can spell that, though. C.
It's pronounced Gordon.
I like to buy a vowel.
Oh, my God.
All right, next story.
You crazy. Oh, here's a funny story. Okay, so a sneaker company offered more money to Michael Jordan than Nike and Adidas back in 1984, which, by the way, was the best year of that century. That's the year I was born. An article written by Brandon Richard for Soul Collector.
I have nothing for you.
Sorry, Brandon. During a recent podcast, long time sneaker industry insider Sonny Vaccaro credited himself for delivering Michael Jordan to Nike in 1984. In response to Sonny's claims, Jordan's agent, David Falk, recently spoke to ESPN and set the record straight. I don't like how ESPN is getting all this groundbreaking sneaker news all of a sudden.
They know what's hot.
They got dude from Slam over there.
They been had him over there.
Yeah. Scoop.
Yeah. No, now they want to use him. He's been over there
they
for like 20 years.
They doing kicks on court top 10 on ESPN.
Hey, you know, are they?
For the playoffs, yeah.
What? You notice the front of Scoop's S curl kind of like ain't really curling like that. I think that's a toupee. But keep going, dog.
You got that Steve Harvey action going.
Yeah.
In response to Sonny's claims, Jordan's agent, David Falk, recently spoke to ESPN to set the record straight. Falk downplayed Sonny's influence on Nike's decision to sign Jordan by calling it a no-brainer. David said it wasn't that revolutionary for Sonny to tell Nike to sign Michael. He was the national player of the year. It wasn't like he was some sleeper. Perhaps the most fascinating tidbit from the interview is the revelation of which company actually offered the most money to Jordan. And no, it was not Nike. According to David, relatively unknown company, Spot Built. Wow, that's a weird name to spell it. Weird way to spell it. Submitted the highest offer exceeding Nike's winning bid of $500,000 annually. Spot Built, best known for creating O.J. Simpson's signature cleats and a basketball model for Xavier McDaniel. Well, no wonder he turned it down.
X-Man.
Was ran by the same manufacturing company that made Saucony runners. David also added that Converse offered Jordan $100,000 and that Adidas had almost no interest.
Yeah, I actually read this. The other day or whatever. Jordan ultimately picked the right thing.
Yeah, it was.
Like, ultimately.
Yeah.
But it's just funny. Adidas wanted no parts, bro. And he really wanted to be a part of Adidas.
I know. That got a hold on for life.
Yeah.
Michael Jordan's rolling over his grave right now. Former Nike inventor loses lawsuit against Adidas. In an article written by Brandon Doon for Soul Collector.
Well, you gonna hit another note. dun. There we go, bro.
Doom.
Yeah.
You at the end.
Like Melvin.
Yeah.
Ba 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 boo. an inventor who worked for Nike in the 1990s lost a lawsuit against Adidas over alleged trademark and patent infringement. Robert M. Leiden filed the suit in October 2014 that alleged Adidas ripped off his spring shoe design for a spring blade running sneaker. In the filing, Robert says certain innovative footwear structures associated with the Adidas spring blade shoes have been previously disclosed to Adidas by him and several other individuals who had acted on his behalf, including former Adidas America Incorporated CEO Peter Moore and Michael Pavito between 2005 and 2009. Adidas' spring blade didn't release until 2013. According to the fashion law, a judge in the U.S. District Court for the District of Oregon decided that Robert's patents for his spring shoe design haven't been infringed upon by Adidas. Robert's name recently appeared in another footwear lawsuit via the bizarre allegations of Daisy Washington Cross and her $3 billion claim against Nike. Mm. Yeah, remember that. That's the lady from Michigan who said,
What is a statute of limitation for suing a company? Because I feel like, because I know that Nike stole my camo design for the Foamposite. Mm. So there's a lawyer out there that wants to take that up and I can sue them. Come see me.
There's a lot of people getting sued. It seems like these companies spend more time in court than actually making shoes. Because right now we got the next story. Adidas and Under Armour reach confidential settlement agreement and lawsuit. An article written by Brandon Doon for Soul Collector.
Doon!
What?
Yeah, bro. You don't even know.
That's all for you, Brandon.
We used to win all the concerts. We the first ever
duo quartet.
I got nothing but love
for you, baby.
A lawsuit.
A lawsuit filed by Adidas.
I got sunshine. A lawsuit filed by Adidas against Under Armour wrapped up recently with the parties coming to a confidential settlement agreement.
Stupid phone from vibrating, bro.
I don't know who's some bill collector.
pay your bills.
Damn it. I set myself up for that one. In the claim, which was filed in 2014, Adidas alleged that Under Armour infringed on his fitness tracking tech patents via MapMyFitness, a company Under Armour acquired in 2013. According to Adidas, Under Armour will now pay Adidas a licensing fee in exchange for use of its patents on its MapMyFitness platform going forward. The lawsuit mentioned that the Director of Innovation and Research at Under Armour formerly worked at Adidas as a senior innovation engineering manager and had knowledge of Adidas tech patents. So I guess...
tech patents?
No. But they did have that running shoe. They did have like the first one that could like track your footsteps and all that other stuff.
They running shoes did not matter until this past year.
Ooh. Take that, Adidas.
Jeez, bro. He's not shooting blanks.
Right. He's like, your mama's so fat.
Right.
Oh, my God. Let me see. We got this next one. Oh, my God. Okay. Court shuts down Adidas' attempt to block Puma shoes. So while they won against Under Armour, I guess they took an L against Puma. An article written by Brandon Doon for Soul Collector.
Doon!
Doon, 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 doon.
Doon, 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 doon.
Oh, my God. Adidas wanted to stop Puma from producing his Boost-like, I guess, energy line of sneakers. But German courts aren't letting it happen. Fortune reports that Adidas sought an injunction to stop Puma from selling shoes from his energy line and lost his case in Dusseldorf Regional Court. Puma.
It's pronounced Gordon.
That's what you call it is, right? That's what the Lord of the Rings.
Oh, my bad. Dusseldorf, my bad. It's Dusseldorf.
Dusseldorf.
Dusseldorf? Is it Dusseldorf?
Is that Harry Potter?
I know.
You ready?
Is it in you? Puma was working with BSF, the same company that developed Adidas Boost technology. I thought it was NASA. They keep changing.
I know what whatever. BSF can mean.
Yeah. Until it struck an exclusive deal with Adidas over the cushioning tech in 2011. After that, Puma found a new partner in Huntsman Corp and launched his energy line in 2014. Neil Nariman, head of intellectual property at Puma, says the brand has held back.
It's like he has mind control over people.
Yeah, it does. He'd be in a new X-Men movie. He's one of the four horsemen.
Professor Xavier's young nephew.
Right, Neil Neriman. Says the brand has held back on bringing many of its energy designs to market in light of the litigation, but that it will move forward with promoting the Boost rival. So heads up for the energy line. All right. What's next? Ooh, I guess Kina is going to do stories that sneaker stories that make you go.
Aww. Sneaker stories that make you go, aw. A 13-year-old girl gave new Nike sneakers to a kid who was being bullied. In an article written by Riley Jones for Complex.
Don't you dare in your life call me Kurt.
Wow, that's like Tina Turner, Ike Jones. I mean,
Turner,
Ike
Jones. I just know.
Ike Jones?
Ike Jones.
Fired up.
Ike Jones.
Ike Jones.
Wow.
Smack that article, Ike Jones.
Oh, my God. Okay, I'm going to stop.
As kids gathered to shoot hoops in Louisville, Kentucky neighborhood, a 13-year-old girl noticed that a younger boy was being bullied over his shoes, and that's when she stepped up to make a difference. WDRB reports that 13-year-old Shaylin Hampton hooked the kid up. She hooked the kid up with a brand new Nike LeBron sneaker. The little boys playing were making fun of his shoes because basically they were not what you call designer. Shaylin says Shaylin retrieved the LeBrons from her own collection.
Nice. Aww. Good job, Shaylin.
There we go. Sweet. Oh, aww. Wow.
Drop one of Kina's arms for Shaylin. All right.
So nice.
Kina could actually just probably get one of her pair of shoes to the little boy because she, like, wears a size 3. Aww.
That's not funny.
That's what the audience decides to say.
That's not funny.
You got one more for us?
One more, yeah. Neo to auction off sneakers from his personal collection for charity. In an article written by Brandon Dune for Soul Collector.
Dune.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, I was a baritone, bro. You right.
I thought that was E.T. for a second.
Yeah, you didn't know I was a baritone, bro.
Brandon Dune. Phone home.
That's why you don't sing. That's
I know.
You're so stupid, Juan.
Yeah, you are. Right.
Thank you, D.D.
The R&B singer Neo auctioned off sneakers from his own closet for the Walk in Our Shoes series of charity auctions. Partnering with StockX, users were able to bid on more than 20 pairs from Neo's collection. All the money that was raised went to the Compound Foundation's Music Academy Boot Camp, and annual... Wait, where'd it go?
The words didn't actually need to
pay. I got
still,
it.
She still has to have
the words are walking off. Well,
no, because
she still has to put the ruler like under the words.
All right. Okay.
Hey, you know what's crazy? Like, I used to say, like, people who listen to Gucci Man read with their finger.
That's not
what you pulled up.
That's not
what she walked in humming Lemonade. She's
like, oh,
whatever.
God.
Basically, it was an annual giving tour. Neo started the Compound Foundation, which provides support to kids growing up in a foster care and youth homes, in 2007. Neo released this statement, growing up in a foster care and youth... Oops.
Yeah, get that ruler out.
Yeah. Let me use this pen. It's been a long weekend, okay? Neo released this statement, advocating for children, most of whom have faced challenging circumstances. In my passion... and mission for the Compound Foundation, I am proud to be a part of the Walk in Our Shoes campaign that provides a fantastic opportunity to use my sneakers as a force for good.
There you go.
Neo's.
I don't know which one is more of an awe moment. Her Neo's finishing sweet. Reading it or Neo? I feel like, I just watched the baby learn how to walk.
No.
Kina, read this.
I know.
Listen. Listen,
shit, I tried
Linda.
To hide.
She no.
Tried to play sleeper club.
She got the sunglasses on, but we can still see her.
Am I invisible?
Listen, I'm invisible. Listen.
All right, let's pay some bills and then let's get into this week in stupid.
Crep Protect. I put that shit on everything. Go to crepprotect.com and get your shoes some protection.
Your
Are you
shoes.
Stupid or something? Honestly, as stupid as stupid does.
Yes. One of the stupid things that happened this week, factories that create fake sneakers have begun producing the Air Jordan 1s based on the Photoshop picture that went viral.
I actually seen that. That was hilarious.
Wow. That's hilarious.
They are quick.
Yeah, they like, we about to beat it. We about to get this. So, so we don't even know what the Air Jordans are going to look like, but obviously.
Is that the same factory that got shut down, my man, that had the fake website?
You know what? Supply PDX. Yeah, yeah, you can get your, what the
PDX is.
I am
warning all people right now, do not come to my store with them shoes on, talking about you got them early before they came out.
Yeah.
I will flame you. I will destroy your life, and I will make your mother feel like she should have swallowed you.
Wow, that is.
Aww. Wow, that's crazy. That is not an aw.
No, that aw was from the person that walked in.
Like, oh, I better change my shoes.
Yeah. Oh man, okay, this is, I want to get a couple of things out of the way. All right, so Chinese brand Uncle Martian
again.
Yeah, they out here. It's now ripping off Stephen Curry's Under Armour sneaker design. An article written by Marco Henry Negrete for Complex.
You know you my Negrete.
Just days after denying that it ripped off Under Armour's logo, Chinese brand Uncle Martian, which sounds like the dumbest name to any company. It's like they just picked two random words that started with a U and an M.
Kind of like Kid Robot.
Yeah, just ridiculous. Now looks to have steeped even lower by copying Steph Curry's signature line. Uncle Martian now has photos of the Under Armour Curry 1 and 2 sneakers on his site. Like the actual shoe replaced with this this Photoshop logo. Wow.
I rock with that.
At first glance, like they just brazen.
Steal it like we gonna steal this Western Conference Finals and OKC go to the finals.
Okay. At first glance, it may not appear.
Is Bobby Boucher going to show up at the Bourbon Bowl?
Mr. Stephen Curry, I'm a favorite fan of yours.
The water sucks. Gatorade is better.
Mr. Curry, I would humbly respect if you don't say that.
You're wrong, Colonel Sanders.
Like, good luck on the next play. I'm going to good luck with your mama tonight. Number 62. All right. At
there
first
you
glance.
Are.
Get on the ball. I'm watching that tonight, dude. Like, I ain't seen that movie in so long. At first glance, it may not appear like anything is wrong, but that's only because this logo so closely resembles the famous Under Armour logo. While no one should be surprised considering that they blatantly ripped off Under Armour's logo, no one expected them to completely try to claim actual sneaker designs as their own. What the hell is that?
No.
Oh. Yeah, that's Uncle Marsha. It's ridiculous.
The one thing is, with them being in a whole different country, you know what I'm saying? Like, continent, whatever.
Yeah.
I don't know why this keeps happening. But I don't know. With them being in a whole different continent and, like, their own laws and all of that stuff, I don't know why. They're probably going to go ahead and – they are suing them, right?
They are trying to, but you know how it goes in China.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, good luck with that. Michael Jordan can't win.
Yeah.
If you know, if Michael Jordan can't win in China, you already know as another up-and-start company, you probably have no chance.
Right.
But, you know, shoot your shot. This one I've been wanting to get off. Andre Agassi. This is crazy. Had doctors put a Nike swoosh on his skin. On an article written by Brandon Doom for Soul Collector.
Doom.
In a new video from Unscripted, tennis legend Andre Agassi explained that he got Nike's brand mark on his body in 1993 after a wrist surgery. He said, "To show my loyalty to Nike, I asked the doctors when they cut it open if they could kind of do it in a swoosh. So I could just be branded, I guess." The doctors didn't do a great job at recreating the logo, and the scar is tough to see in the clip. Ironically, Andre has not been a Nike athlete for the entirety of his tennis career. He started with the brand in 1988, left for Adidas in 2005, and re-signed back to Nike in 2013. Mm. So, yeah, that's pretty dumb.
Yeah. Kinda,
that's one of those stories that I didn't need to know. but we read it on the show. Lionel.
That's just crazy.
Lionel from Chicago.
Hello, hello.
Tell them why you mad, son.
Yes. Do you know why you're mad this week?
What's going on? Only if y'all have still been talking about Chicago or the Chicago teams, man.
The Chicago teams was horrible, but go ahead.
See, now I got a problem. At least they made a Chicago 10, not a Detroit 10.
Mm. Oh, don't worry. We got a Detroit 6.
Yeah.
Don't worry about it.
We got our shoe first.
We got a Piston 6 that actually is sweet.
Yeah.
Black with the patent and the suede. Red and blue on the bottom.
Nah.
You might have saw an actual champion wearing them.
Yeah.
Unlike your broken knee person who hasn't won anything since high school. But he did win. He did win like four championships in high school where it's amateurs.
You know, the Bulls may be quote unquote bad, but at least our baseball team's good. Both of them.
They're gonna choke.
Yeah.
Right now.
Yeah, they're gonna break your heart eventually.
Too, bro.
I say right now.
1908.
It ain't even been All-Star break yet.
I know.
Yeah, this part.
Weren't they good last year? What happened?
It's the reason why they're called Cubs and not Bears.
Yeah, there you go.
They're still babies out here, bro.
The Cubs and Derrick Rose, PJ Rose threw out the first pitch at the game.
Yeah, that was good. That was good. Why? He's quick at the hip.
They not as good. That good. They got Warren G singing "Take Me Out to the Ball Game."
Ooh, yeah. That right there is just jinx show season right there.
Regulators, mound up.
Cubbies, mound up.
Man, everything
I heard
good
a woman's
way,
laugh.
You say what?
I'm good. I heard a woman's laugh.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Shoot your shot, man.
Yes.
It's a lady in here.
Shoot your shot.
Behold.
Yes. How you doing today?
I'm good at yourself.
I'm going to turn my mic off.
I'm good. I'm all right. I just want to say hi. That's all.
Okay. Hey.
Behold.
I am close to spectacular.
A lady.
Oh,
hey, are you panting over there? It sounds like you panting over there.
Right. I think you got asthma.
Nah, I'm
good. I think
you on the south side of Chicago right now, running for your life?
He got the Chicago tears on with the Chicago flag running around like Usain Bolt running around.
he's definitely one of my favorite callers, man.
He takes abuse every week.
You call in next week and you tell us why you mad.
You know what's crazy is people actually start thinking I know it's a part of the show.
He's our new team. We just abuse him every week.
give me a couple more stories, bro.
All right. Okay, here's one. This is not so stupid, but it's just like, how do you know you have this skill? Sneaker store employee can identify shoes just by smelling them.
What?
Right.
I seen
an article. An article written by Riley Jones for Complex.
If you call me Curry, I'll go upside your head.
Get a head up and coming.
Upside your head.
Jamie of Riff LA says that he has the ability to identify shoes based on their smell. In a video for Sneaker Watch, you can clearly see Jamie sniffing each shoe and identifying them correctly. So he's just huffing shoes out there. Elsewhere in the video, Jamie sheds light on Riff LA's process for spotting fake sneakers, and more importantly, the store's policy for dealing with customers who bring in said fakes.
I've seen that video, and it's like, it would have been more impressive if he just walked through the stock room, just grabbed a random shoe, and then smelt it. But they had, like, shoes sitting in front of him, so he kind of knew. It could have been this, it could have been that.
But how do you know you had that skill, though? Like, at what, like, it starts with one, right? You had to just, like, literally pick up the first shoe and just go.
Well, didn't we say pandas identify things by smell?
So he's half man, half panda?
Maybe.
Wow. How much time we got? We good?
We got We got time for two more.
Real quick. An article written by Amir Ismail for Complex, Reddit user at not want to say Atodiso. I don't know how you spell that the way he did, but he did. Shared pictures of his white cement Air Jordan 4s covered in mold. One might assume that they were a 1999 pair that's been in storage for quite some time, but no. His pair is the recently released remastered version that has been worn and then put away in the box for only 1 week. After smelling something rancid, he discovered mold that ironically matched his sneakers. Black mold on the side and laces, white mold on the toe cap, and red mold on the tongue. I've seen the pictures of them, and they look, those things are horrible. I don't even know how they get like that.
That's called athlete.
You know, I had one for Amir, but you messed it up. You didn't give me a chance.
Sorry, Amir.
Next time, Amir.
You want to do it now?
Nope.
No,
it's going to be a surprise from Mirror. That's if you write another article.
So Brandon, ooh, wow. So Brandon Richards is even worth the time then, huh?
Not right now.
Damn.
He's got two first names, bro. I don't trust him.
Oh, man.
If you bet you don't.
I want to get these last two stories in. Hopefully I got enough time. Ja Rule believed that Michael Jordan collects royalties on the crying MJ meme. No, it's not sneaker related, but it was so dumb I had to put it in here.
Yeah.
An article written by Vanessa de Beaumont.
Ooh.
For
a lady.
Bleacher Report. According to Ja Rule, baby, the internet famous crying Jordan meme belongs on the list of things that Michael, well, yeah, he believes that they belong on the list of things that Michael Jordan receives earnings from. Apparently, Ja got his information from the satirical site TMZ Comedy. After reading the intentional misinformation on TMZ Comedy, Ja went to Twitter and wrote, "This is why I love America. While we all laughing at the Jordan grind face, he gets a dollar every time he gets posts. Jokes on us!" Obviously,
was he on the toilet?
That was actually audio, Ja Rule. Obviously, Ja was sorely mistaken, and Twitter wasted no time posting the Jordan crying face on Ja Rule's body and tagging him in the pictures.
Black Twitter is a mug.
I'm telling you, man, I love it.
You got regular Twitter.
The internet is undefeated.
I love how people like go to like fake websites and act like they getting like credible information.
I just want to know who's the guy that is just literally ready to put Jordan Cryface on everything.
Somebody is.
Jordan Cryface, it may be Jordan. Up.
Wait till we release the picture for this podcast. It's gonna have Caesar in a Spurs jersey with a cryface.
that hurt.
Because Popovich Cryface was amazing, bro.
All right. So family says light up sneakers lit their car on fire. An article written by Brandon Noon for Soul Collector.
I ain't got nothing else.
Doom, Brandon.
Yeah.
Doom, Brandon. That's Doom. Brandon, the remix.
Wow. Parents in Texas are blaming a mysterious car fire on a pair of light-up sneakers they purchased for the toddler. Ooh, man. Attila and Jovan Virag.
Wow. What? Okay.
You almost, like, with those names like that, you almost deserve it.
They sound like evil Disney characters.
Attila and Jovan.
Disneyland. See, it's Disneyland. He like, where? I love the way he says it. Say that again. Disneyland.
He loves Disneyland.
They discovered the damage from the fire inside the SUV after seeing smoke inside the vehicle. The passenger seat had melted, and there was a hole burned through the back seat. While the local fire marshal's office has yet to confirm it, the parents speculate that their son's light-up shoes that were left in the car started the fire. There just wasn't anything in there to start a fire, Jovan said. Only shoes and clothes. The parents are planning to get in touch with Payless, where they bought the shoes that they believe caused the fire. And I think Payless... So
the same people that made the hoverboards made those light-up shoes?
I guess so. And I think Payless has pulled the shoes off the shelves. I think we got actual audio of somebody, a witness to the fire.
Well, I woke up to go get me a cold pop. Then I thought somebody was barbecuing. I said, oh, Lord Jesus, it's a fire.
I said, oh, Lord Jesus,
then
it's a fire.
I ran out. I didn't grab no shoes or nothing, Jesus.
Wow.
I ran for my life. And then the smoke got me. I got bronchitis. Ain't nobody got time for that.
You know what's funny?
Ain't nobody got time for that.
She said she got her shoe. Like, she said Jesus as if Jesus was the one interviewing her.
I said, oh, Lord Jesus.
Like, I didn't get my shoes, Jesus. Like, Jesus like, all right, so what happened next?
That is one of my favorite videos all time. Yeah. The remix, the song is hilarious. Yeah,
I had it as a ringtone for a while.
Oh, my God.
I wanted to do a new segment this week. We're constantly trying to think of ways to keep you guys entertained. So this week we got this new segment called Dirty YouTube Sneaker Review Videos, where basically we just pick videos at random. And
Mr. Potty Mouth.
Yeah.
Watch your language, Mr. Dirty Mouth.
Yes. So we wanted this week to start it off with our friend of the show, one of our favorite guys on YouTube, Mike Rich. He had a video recently. It was pretty messed up. I don't know if I let my child watch it, but
when your team get and you still lit, yes, hoax, baby, hoax. Anyway, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy Mike Rich, man, and this is Rich's. y'all go back a couple of videos ago. Well, I forgot which video. What video was that? Anyway, when the sports talk aside, the purpose of this video is the cop that I got recently.
Whoa!
The vlog will probably go up before this video. Yeah, so this video is going to go up. I'm going to try to get this video up after the vlog.
Oh, man.
What, he put the porn up?
Whoa. I went to Heat ATL. Black bag action.
Oh!
sneaker consignment / retail shop in Atlanta. They get sneakers.
Mike is going to kill
consignment. Me. They get sneakers and not consignment. I'm not really sure if they got a Nike account or not, but I know they had a lot of sneakers that
were my God.
Not consignment. And these were not consignment. So these are the Air Jordan 4 Retro LS, Oreo 4 Action, Black Tech, Gray and Black. They retail for $190, y'all know. and I paid $250.
That's a good
probably could have got them cheaper than that on eBay or something like that, but hey, they was right there. They was dead stock, brand new. I had them.
Oh, you did what to the shoe, Michael?
But not gonna do a review, y'all. Oh. Y'all know what it is, but I'm glad I was finally able to.
So why are you doing the video if you're not doing the review?
Sir.
Jeez.
Leather.
Oh, Michael.
Action, man.
Wow.
This shoe. Didn't get it when it first released because my wife pretty much told me to slow down on buying sneakers.
Does she know about this?
I don't know.
A pair of shoes in like 2 weeks. And she was like, you need to slow down. And then when these dropped, I was like, well, I'm getting them. And she was like, no, you're not getting them.
Whoa.
She called him on his name.
Right.
She was like, you're not getting them.
Abuse goes both ways, Mike.
Wait for a while to get them. But they dope.
Oh,
you gotta do what the old lady say.
Verbal abuse is verbal abuse.
Yes, it is. That. No matter who says it.
Old lady say. Plus, she keep me. If it weren't for her, I probably.
Whoa. Everybody. Huh?
Like, even the colorways that I don't even care about that much, I probably would.
Would you do that? All the shoes.
I know y'all want to see them on feet, so let me let y'all go on ahead and check these out on feet, man.
Yes.
Oh, he's outside right now.
The Air Jordan.
Oh man, Mike, don't do anything crazy outside.
Oh,
yeah, man.
A dove just flew off, bro. This is so indecent.
I don't know. I like them. I like them both ways, actually.
Whoa.
Oh no.
In my opinion.
In my opinion.
Do some walk away. Let's do some walk away. How about we do some walk away? Very nice. Get some booty, man.
Whoa. Oh, no.
No booty.
Oh. Oh, Michael.
Get a little walk by. Get you some.
That's what you talk to your neighbors.
He just rocking out with his cock out now at this point, huh?
Get you some.
Right.
He's real quick on feet. Want to show y'all. First.
Whoa. Even the birds are freaks.
The birds didn't do anything to you, Mike.
Oh, my God.
In the morning. Anyway, cleanse. That's those on feet. As y'all can see. Love this shoe. This shoe right here, I can see myself wearing a lot.
Oh, man.
Anyway, it's neither here.
So does he do that to the shoes and wear them?
Whoa, hopefully somebody out there did not buy a pair of used Mike Rich shoes.
Videos, man.
So does
that's
it,
what I'm here
like
for.
That's why the Whoa. Little side of his shoes be leaning?
Man.
Oh, man.
Oh, my God. Mike. Okay, Mike Rich. That was just out of control, Mike.
Mike.
Get it together. I tried to watch a video with my daughter, and you just started going off.
Mike going to send all 100,000 of subscribers.
I know.
You that right now.
So if Beyonce has the beehive, like what does Mike have? Like, what is it? The
richers.
The rich.
What is that big T in the lawn?
Get yourself.
It stands for time to leave, Richards.
Oh, yeah, time to leave.
Oh,
time to leave. All right, Mike Rich. I know I'm going to get a phone call tonight.
Send him some dentine ice.
You don't really work here.
Yes, you do.
You're going to get you some.
Yeah, sports.
It sounds like he got him some.
I see. And the birds.
Yeah.
All right.
And the shoes.
Sports.
Hello, sports fans. I'm Ron Burgundy here at the desk of ESPN. And there were some things going on in sports today that will make your brain fall out of your skull.
Might not have been sports. That made it roll out your skull after that video. Man, I don't even know where to start.
Mike.
Well. we got conference final set. Golden State and OKC. Mm.
Hey!
I see this going seven.
And you make no more predictions.
I just
you
I
don't
see it going
get
seven.
To do a damn. Because you had a gentleman.
Okay, at least I had a prediction. Like, everybody was quiet until
gentleman
they won.
Gentleman sweep of five for the Spurs.
I was scared. I was, bro.
Kawhi not.
Kawhi.
Ooh,
not.
Wow.
And then you got Cleveland and Toronto.
Or as they call them, Believeland.
Believeland. Splashland, Ohio.
I didn't watch that 30 for 30.
I didn't either.
I coined it. Used that.
You know, Guru, like, probably recorded it and probably selling the bootlegs right now. That villa.
That's it. Yeah, so we got the Golden State Warriors, the OKC Thunder, Splashland Cavaliers, and the Aubrey
it's
Raptors.
It's pronounced Gordon.
The Aubrey Raptors.
Yeah.
Passing out lemonade on the sidelines. Yeah, I you know, honestly, I mean, I kind of know how the Cleveland thing is going to go. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't be surprised if Cleveland swept them, too.
I don't think it's going to be a sweep, but I wouldn't be surprised by it.
Listen, dog, for as long as I've known, the Eastern Conference has been so watered down. Mm-hmm. And usually, like, the second seed is still, like, good. But I don't think Toronto is, like, a proven second seed.
What
like
was that. The best series on the East is...
in the last few years?
No, just this year. What was the best series?
The Charlotte and Miami.
Yeah. And that tells you a lot right there. That's my point. Like, that tells you a lot. And the Charlotte Miami is like the best series
out of the... Dwayne Wade turned into Father Prime. That's his new new coin term. He's no longer the Flash. He's Father Prime.
Wow.
NBA 2K16, in honor of Steph Curry winning the United's MVP... unanimous MVP.
Yeah.
They did a 30 hours of Steph Curry break the game where they maxed out his rating. Well, he was the greatest player in 2K history. And really? Some person actually broke the game by scoring 334 points and shooting 102 three-pointers.
What?
With Steph Curry.
What?
It was ridiculous.
Wow.
For a whole, he played a whole 48-minute game and he really, like, broke the game.
I mean, wow.
That's like the old school NBA Jam days, bro, where you wouldn't let the computer dribble the ball at all.
Yeah. It was like no game sliders or nothing. Like, Steph was just shooting from half court, contested, fadeaway, running, and then all.
How crazy is that? Like, somebody's shooting that proficient to where, like, the video game has trouble keeping up, where they just like, you know what, max them out.
Yeah. Bro, he did seriously hit 400 threes.
402.
Before him, nobody had hit 300 threes.
Yeah, it was like 280-something.
Yeah.
Steph Curry has broken his record.
Yeah, like, he broke the record for three years in a row.
3 years in a row.
And on top, like, the thing is, Klay made, like, almost 300 three-pointers this year. Nobody talked about it.
Because, yeah, you got somebody shooting 400. I mean,
Klay is number two.
Kind of a footnote on the list. At that point.
Like, he broke Steph records.
Yeah, he broke his second. Yeah.
He's broke his second and third record.
Wow.
Oh,
I mean, real quick, what do everybody think about this? Oh, I maybe I should let you finish first. I was going to ask, like, what do everybody think about everybody bitching about the fact that he's the first unanimous?
I'll let the sportsman go first.
But, I mean, he had a remarkable season. Unanimous, I can't really say, but the thing is, LeBron is being hurt by being in the Eastern Conference because it's so watered down, and then he's being a product of his own success. Because
he came in third.
Yeah. But he's a product of his own success. It's like it's hurting him because it's like he's averaging 29 points a game, but it's normal. Like, people are not looking like, oh, LeBron is like doing something spectacular. It's like LeBron is doing what LeBron's supposed to do.
I think when it comes to that,
I kind of agree with that.
I think with him having a point guard now, the ball isn't in LeBron's hands as much.
Right.
When he didn't, like all the years he didn't have a point guard, he was putting up triple doubles. He had high assist numbers, which his assist numbers are still good.
Yeah. Right.
It's like 6.7 or something like that.
Yeah.
They're still good. But there comes a time where every year you have to increase your level. When Michael Jordan was in the league, every year he got better.
Yeah.
As he got older, he just found ways to get better in other ways. There was never a time where you said, it looks like Michael Jordan slowing down, except for when he came back for the love of the game and played for Washington. But that was strictly for the love of the game.
And he still averaged 20, yeah.
I feel like Kawhi Leonard didn't get a first-place vote because quietly as great as he is, he doesn't make no noise like that. You know what I'm saying?
What sound
does a dunk make when it's on mute?
Right. Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? So I believe that. But, as much of the face as LeBron is in the league, a lot of off-the-court things is what really probably stopped LeBron from coming in second place.
And my thing is with LeBron is I don't think like LeBron has four MVPs. I don't think he's really chasing MVPs anymore. It's like championship or bust.
But, yeah, you know, what is he chasing, though? Because
he's kind
of – he wants to be known as the greatest ever, right? But to me, he's not doing greatest ever things.
I think his sole purpose right now is to make sure Cleveland gets a championship.
But then, I would agree with that. But then he makes comments like, you know, well, we need to define what MVP is. Did you make that argument when you won? Like, you know, basically,
I mean, but
Stephen Curry is the first person in history with 400 threes, led the league in scoring. He led the league in steals. He shot 90% from the free throw line, 50% from the field, 40% from three. what people don't understand is most of his points came from the paint.
Exactly.
It didn't come from the three-point line.
Right.
And but, you know what I'm saying?
But you know what?
But so who's broke all of these?
But on top of that, hold on. But on top of that, he did that from the beginning of the season all the way through.
Like there was times where LeBron was inconsistent. There was times where Kawhi Leonard
was inconsistent. They led from the very beginning to the end.
But
to
73-9.
But to contradict that, Steph's team just won two playoff series basically without him.
That means
in
nothing,
the West.
Right.
In the West. Wait. In the West, they won basically two playoff series without him.
Well, actually, they didn't, bro. Because
well,
they
technically
lost,
won.
They lost those games. Steph Curry came back and they won those last two games.
They lost one game.
They might have lost game five or game, was that four? They might have lost
game four.
They were
going to win that series regardless.
They would have won the series, but it would have been a lot tighter.
If Cleveland, if LeBron set out one, if LeBron set out any of those series, Cleveland wouldn't have won the game.
Well, okay, two things. One, the MVP is for the season, not the playoffs. Two,
I'm saying like if you LeBron's argument was valuable.
No,
that's the term.
Look at the definition that they said: the most valuable season. Like who's having the best season? Now who's most valuable to your play? Because if that's the case, Damian Lillard. I mean, take him off that team. They're
like,
not in the playoffs.
That's what I'm saying. It's like the MVP by the NBA standard of the word, or is like the best player, but the most valuable person.
I think
on
y'all
the team.
Trying to get too steep with this. Right now, Steph Curry is the best player.
Yeah, I'm not
arguing.
Exactly.
He's the best player in the NBA. LeBron is not the best player in the NBA.
Not this season. Not this saying season. Ever. Just saying this season.
No, right now, LeBron is not the best player in the NBA.
No, that's what I'm saying.
And it is an argument that Kawhi Leonard is more valuable to his team than LeBron is valuable to his team.
I think LaMarcus is a little more valuable.
But I would say this, too, though. You can see.
Overweight LaMarcus is doing nothing, bro.
I would say
he's the reason they lost.
Yeah, he did kind of fade off. But I will say this, though. If you look at the games they play, the Golden State Warriors, and those the series against the Rockets and the series against Portland, you can see their offense wasn't as fluid because Steph Curry stretches that defense. Because he's the ball handler. You got to check him that full length of the court.
Klay averaged 30.
No, I'm saying. But you see that they was able to kind of like.
Klay has the most points in the playoffs this season.
I'm not saying he didn't. I'm just saying that the defense.
A great team is a great team, though. So who cares if it's a great team? He's blessed to have a great team. But everybody knows if Stephen Curry wouldn't have been playing on that team, they would have won 50 to 55 games in the season.
Yes.
They wouldn't have been the first seed, and they wouldn't be able to cruise the way they cruise. You know
Cleveland
what I'm saying?
Might not have made the playoffs.
They would have made the playoffs.
Bro, but who cares at the end of the day, bro?
They would have made the
playoffs. I'm just saying.
You know what's funny?
They're first place, but what was Cleveland? What was Cleveland's last what was Cleveland record?
Like 50 something?
7 or 56.
Cleveland in the Western Conference would have been a third or fourth seed.
Right now, yeah.
They would have been a third or fourth seed, bro.
Right.
Their best record, usually when somebody has the best record in the Eastern Conference and a person has the best record in the Western Conference, it's usually 1-2.
Yeah. I mean, I think it was a season with, like, the seventh seed had 50 wins in it.
That's what I'm
Western
saying,
Conference.
Bro.
I would say this, too. Like, what annoys me to hell is, in the recent arguments, is how, like, people say, well, if LeBron wasn't on his team right now, they wouldn't make the playoffs. Okay, if that's the case, then you shouldn't complain about not having Kyrie Irving. And if the team is that shitty, right, it doesn't matter what teammate you got that, you know, LeBron plays with because, obviously, he's the one making them good. So I don't want to hear no argument, well, we didn't have this guy last year. We didn't have that guy last year. Well, according to you, they would have made the playoffs, so therefore they're not that good, so why miss them? And if they are that good, give them their props and say, you know what, they might not have been the number one seed, but they definitely would have made the playoffs.
I don't understand why not give him his just dues and why be thankful.
Because he's
LeBron.
The first unanimous,
yeah,
and I get it.
I mean,
like, Shaq
like,
should have got
it's
it.
Like, get off LeBron.
Michael
nuts,
Jordan
should
have got
that,
it.
He's not that great, bro.
LeBron might have should have got it, but just because they deserved it back then.
He shouldn't have got it. At this point in time.
And who cares
why?
If they didn't get, like, at least one vote? Like, what? Like, bro.
You still would have lost.
No, that's the same thing as somebody getting a ribbon for participation.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, what? He gets one vote.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
So, like, the kid that come in seventh place or whatever, he still gets a ribbon. So, it was just supposed to stroke LeBron's
ego. First place
just
still,
to give him...
But first place is still first place.
Yeah, but I'm just saying,
right.
Like...
Right.
This because we can go all day about this. We're going to move on from that.
It's your segment. Yeah, I forgot. Let's go ahead.
All right, well, to finish the video game segment, is Gronk is going to be on the cover of Madden 17. So it's really bad for my Patriots. We got Tom Brady out and Gronk on the cover. We're cursed. We're going 8-8. I'm calling it.
Man.
We got to get to the MLB fight or WWE MLB.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Fight night.
Odor and Batista, it got real bad blood. It was probably the cleanest professional sports blow I've seen since Chris Childs.
Nah, probably. Since
that two-piece special
Zimmerman got jawed by what you call it?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Yeah. In the Boston, New York.
I don't think it was that clean though. That was clean.
He grabbed him by the back of his head and he threw him down.
He knocked his glasses off. Like he punched the glasses off his face. That was clean.
He had him wavy too. Yeah. He couldn't stand up.
I remember. I mean, the cleanest punch I remember seeing, it was a Jermaine O'Neal when he had the fight at
the
Palace.
That was a sucker punch. So I don't count that as a clean punch. But, like,
that's true. And it was on a regular pedestrian.
But he slid into, like, he did on this baseball slide punch.
The cleaner punch was Ben Wallace's brother on Fred Jones.
Ooh. Yeah.
The Chargers have entered themselves into the sweepstakes of moving to Vegas.
So, oh, really?
Yeah, now it's a bidding war on what team is leaving L.A. and going to Vegas.
What'd you say last week? A whole bunch of players are going to be suspended.
Yeah.
Yeah, because who's the original team that's going to L.A.?
The Rams.
The Rams are going there, and then they were going to share the stadium with the Chargers.
Yeah.
But and then the Raiders were the first ones to say they want to go to Vegas. And now the Chargers want to handle and go to Vegas with them.
Well, we're going to do a quick rundown. Carl Anthony Towns won the unanimous rookie of the year today.
I agree with that.
Pacers are promoting.
Oh, man. Why didn't somebody else get a vote?
Yeah.
Why didn't Porzingis get a vote?
He was.
Oh, my God.
He got all number two votes.
The outrage.
Oh, Porzingis should at least got one vote for sympathy because he balled out in the beginning.
The Pacers.
F LeBron.
The Pacers are promoting assistant coach Nate McMillan to head coach.
Yeah.
How do y'all feel about that, though? Because I feel like people like Nate McMillan and even Byron Scott, I feel like they're underappreciated, and now the NBA doesn't let a coach for 5 years.
They could have. Oh. I feel like they could have kept Frank Vogel.
I was going to say, if he's going to get Nate McMillan, like, is that really an upgrade?
Frank Vogel is meeting with the Knicks. I like that. I think that'll work out for Melo.
If they let him not have to run the triangle, bro. Yeah, it's time to let that triangle junk go because I think that's what holds the team back.
The team got to buy into the triangle for the triangle to work.
And you need other assistant coaches like a Tex Winter and whoever the other guy was.
Tex Winter is somewhere down in Florida, bro, getting an orange tan. Yeah.
The Spurs plan on courting Mike Conley. They want Mike Conley to come in. And they're interested in the KD sweepstakes.
You said who is?
The Spurs.
Oh. Go to L.A., bro, or go to the Knicks. Go to L.A. or go to the
Knicks.
That's
not happening. He's not
Or KD, go ahead and win the championship and stay in OKC.
Last one real quick.
What's that?
It's a hometown. Kay Felder, Oakland University, second highest max vertical in NBA combine history at 44 inches, and he's only 5'8".
Wow.
From OU. Shout out to Kay Felder doing this thing.
That's crazy, bro.
That is.
Hey, but he still can't jump over Caesar's feet.
Oh, you got some jokes. Oh, my God. I'm laughing so hard, I'm going to have abs.
No, you're not.
I love how you just interrupted your own, like, celebration to respond to that.
Yeah,
we got a caller? Who's this? Who we got? Who's it? What? Name yourself. Oh, Wayne from Chicago.
Wayne from Chicago.
Exactly.
What up, Wayne from
Chicago?
What's
going on, guys?
What's good?
What's going on? Who you talking about? What we got going on? What's the discussion?
We just got done talking about why LeBron didn't get any first place votes, and Batista getting his jaw rocked.
Okay, I'm gonna skip on him getting his jaw rocked.
I would too if I was a Chicago fan.
Because look, because. Older put the BO on him. He put the body odor on him. He killed him.
Yeah, he did.
As far as LeBron not getting the MVP votes, Kawhi was better this year all around.
Yeah,
yep.
You know, Durant had as good of a stretch towards the end as he did.
Westbrook,
you know what
too.
Curry did, and you know what Westbrook did. Westbrook had 19 triple-doubles.
Right. You know what's
and
crazy?
Harden silently had a good year. If you
Man, stop. Okay.
No, Harden.
You had an argument.
You almost had it. But you know what I forgot about, and you could almost look at it as it was still sympathy for LeBron to even get third place votes because to me Westbrook had a better season than LeBron did.
Exactly.
I agree.
But what hurt Westbrook is they couldn't close out games.
Yeah, that's
what hurt Westbrook is the same thing that hurt LeBron in 2011. They're splitting up the votes because you have your teammate that's an MVP candidate as well.
Yeah, that's real. That's
true. That's
real.
That's true. That's a good point.
Yeah, because I mean, I don't think it matters about them closing out games because who had a better record?
Between who?
Exactly.
Didn't OKC have a better record than them?
No.
Or they were right
they
there.
Not.
No, they didn't.
Then better than what?
Cavs? Cleveland had a better record.
I think Cleveland had
but
a better
record. But their record is only like, what, 3-4 games off? So like who better had a who had a really a better
and
season?
Then I think head to head matchup, I think Cleveland got the
really
game.
Like Golden State, then it was San Antonio, then it was Cleveland.
OKC was right there.
OKC was behind the Clippers.
Yeah.
They were OKC is a 4 seed?
Yes.
Or they a 3 seed?
They were 4. 4 seed.
Four versus the one.
Yeah. And then I definitely agree with you. And I like having, so I think sometimes people are too much of fans to where they get so jaded by following whoever's, you know, they're following and are unable to be objective. Like, look, from beginning of the season to the end of the season, Steph Curry, like, just balled his ass
dominated.
Off.
This is 400 threes.
This is my thing with LeBron. It's like, LeBron has to do more than LeBron did to win his previous MVPs, to win another one. That's what he's like.
Or just have the best season.
He's suffering from his own success.
But he did not have, I mean, statistically, he did not have he did not have a better season than Steph Curry.
He nowhere
he
near.
Nobody
bro.
Did.
Nowhere
right.
near.
Right. So, now if LeBron James had broke the 3-point record and did all the stuff Steph Curry did, let the Cavaliers.
He would have had a better season than LeBron James if he would have kept following
Cleveland on Twitter. He probably would have gotten the second place.
No, he actually got better after he unfollowed them.
LeBron had a great season. LeBron averaged like 27.
I'll pull up the numbers right now.
No, I mean, I'm not disagreeing with you. I just wanted to know who actually took the time.
Basically, what I'm saying, LeBron has a point guard. So LeBron can give like the assist thing up. That's cool. Like the whole kind of like Magic Johnson and Oscar Robertson thing, all that. LeBron could just physically just put the team on his back now and ball. He doesn't have to worry about having the ball in his hands. He has developed the post game, so he can stay in the post. LeBron could be averaging 33 points a game, and he could have 8 rebounds a game, and he could dominate that way because his rebounds are more important than his assists.
If we're just gonna get an MVP to the best player in the league, Kobe Bryant would have had it like 8 years in a row. Michael Jordan would have had it like 10 years in a row. It's an individual season, and this season
anything outside of the first place don't really matter.
I agree. Like, I mean, whether he got all the votes or not, you know, it is what it is. He still would have won MVP, but thanks for calling, though.
Wayne from Chicago?
I guess he just said, okay, well.
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, yeah, thanks for calling in, my G. You just got us riled back up.
No doubt.
All right, man. Call back in next week.
Exactly.
Yep, peace.
All right, so obviously we had, was it Miami lost yesterday? In game 7, and then we had San Antonio lose in game 7 to the Thunder. So we're going to call, see if they got a couple shoes. I'm going to start with the finish line of Miami.
What was these shoes going to be called, bro?
I got the DeMar DeRozan Nike Hyper Dunk fire extinguishers.
What?
No.
No.
No. No. I don't know. No. Help me out.
It's got to be something with D Wade, bro.
Jordan OVO.
The leaning Ben Gaze.
The Jordan OVO We the Norths.
What is he with? He's with Lee Ning, right?
Huh?
Yeah. Who's D Wade? Yeah. The leaning cortisone shot. There we go. There we go.
The leaning Father Time.
Yeah. There you go.
Yeah, we called out for the second one.
Hello?
Thank you for calling Finish Line Dolphin Mall. How can I help you?
Yes, I'm looking for... Well, this is the Sneaker Boss Podcast. We're looking for a shoe. Can you help us out?
Yeah, what shoe are you looking for?
I'm looking for the Lening Wave 4 Cortisone Shots.
No, unfortunately not. No, chain through, like Foot Locker, Finish Line, they get any of the Lenings. Only in Miami, it's the edition that gets them.
Okay.
Yeah, it's the only store I get them in store. Besides that, it's all online for that brand.
All right, what about the DeMar DeRozan Nike Hyper Dunk Wintertime in South Beach?
No, unfortunately not. We don't have those either.
Don't have those? Oh, okay. All right. We'll try another store then.
No problem, man.
Thank you. All right,
That was a reach.
That was a reach.
That was a reach.
Champs.
So they don't get that. And who else? Oh, Joe Johnson's on there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Joe Johnson.
What's his? He's a Jordan brand.
Yeah, the Joe Johnson Jordan Father Time.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Let's call the Champs Sports in Miami.
Old man, like with the old man moves. Whatever happened to CDR, bro? Because he had game.
Who?
Chris Douglas Roberts.
He was a Laker at one point.
Yeah, he used to have the moves.
He was
bro.
At OKC, I think.
What was the shoe again?
Joe Johnson.
Jordan took a fly, Father Time.
Father Time.
Can I help you?
All right, this is the Sneaker Boss Podcast. We're looking for a shoe. Can you help us out?
You said this is who?
This is the Sneaker Boss Podcast. We're trying to find a shoe. We're trying to see if you guys got it down in Miami. Can you help us out?
Yeah, what shoe is it?
It's the Joe Johnson Jordan Superfly 4, Father Time.
Absolutely not.
No? Have you seen the shoe?
Not in this store, at least.
Have you seen it?
No. I mean, you can try a bigger mall, like Aventura. Or Dolphin. Maybe they have it, but we didn't get them.
Okay. What about the DeMar DeRozan Nike Hyper Dunk Wintertime in South Beach?
No, we didn't get those either.
Oh, okay. Do y'all get any shoes in South Beach, or is it just...
I mean, we get some shoes. We just don't get too many exclusive shoes.
Okay. Well, thanks for helping us out.
No problem.
Yep. Miami has the worst stock of any shoes I've ever heard.
They got the worst stock of players.
Yeah. Like, they don't get anything. All right, so we're calling the San Antonio stores. Foot Locker San Antonio. You said a good shoe the other day.
Oh, man. You get the Kawhi Knots.
I got one.
The Jordan Russell Westbrook Kawhi Knots.
Hold on, I got one.
Locker River Center, Brittany, how can I help you?
Oh, yes, this is the Sneaker Boss Podcast. We're looking for a shoe. I was wondering if you could help us out.
Sure, what shoe?
I'm looking for the Tim Duncan Nike Air Foamposite Pro AARP.
The Tim Duncan one?
Yeah.
Man, we don't carry those in store. To be honest with you, I don't even think Foot Locker carries them.
Have you heard about the pack at all?
I've heard of it, but I didn't know if it was like a customized...
It already came out. Yeah, it's dope because it actually comes with like a little small AARP card, and you would think it doesn't work.
But it actually does.
If you actually go to CVS, you get a discount like on prescription drugs and Bengay and Ace bandages and things like that. And it's actually pretty cool. Like Tim Duncan actually collabed with CVS on this shoe.
And if you take your receipt to McDonald's, you get a free coffee.
I don't know.
No? Never heard of it?
You should really kind of look for it.
I know. You work at a shoe store. You should know this.
I don't know. They don't sell it at Foot Locker, so.
Yeah, and you sound pretty up in age, so you probably want to get an AARP card or something.
Yeah, you might want to get in that pack. Never too young to think ahead. She just hung up. She was like, enough of this bullshit. All right.
I'm not old.
Let's try the Foot Action in San Antonio.
Oh, man.
The Nike, like, it seemed like for a
Jordan,
second, she was like, is this
Jordan
like real?
Kawhi Leonard, boring.
But I love when they say that they've seen the shoe, when clearly it doesn't exist.
The number you have dialed is not in service.
Oh, this must be a Sports Authority.
What? Oh, my God. You know what? Oh, damn it. I wish we had got another one in San Antonio. I'm about to look up a number real quick.
Let me see this work. I got it.
All right. Oh, you missed out.
What's good, bro? This is Juan Neal at Sneaker Boss Podcast. We were looking for a shoe. We was wondering, could you help?
Say that one more time.
This is Juan Neal of the Sneaker Boss Podcast. We were calling about a shoe. We usually do a shoe check every week on our podcast, and we were looking for a certain shoe.
What shoe are you looking for?
We're looking for the Jordan Kawhi Leonard Boring.
Boring.
Yeah.
They're the
30s,
right?
Yeah, the 30s. It's literally just all black. It don't have no Jumpman on it. The insole is flat. It's just like literally.
Okay, At my shop, at the Foot Action Ingram, we don't have those. I know for sure the Champ here at Ingram Park Mall. I know that for sure, though, they might still have some sizes left over.
Yo, you should cop those, man. They're probably going to be worth a lot of money, bro. Because, like, there's not too many shoes like that boring where it's just nothing on it. No Jumpman or nothing. That shoe's probably going to...
It's going to be worth money.
Yeah.
It's going to resell for millions.
I mean, here's the thing, though, because I know, like, a lot of people that do customs, too. So, like, and you can probably give them more money. you can get that up. Because I know he has one with, like, the San Antonio. He got the San Antonio Tower on one of them. On, like, I think on either on the left or the right one.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah, like, that's what I'm saying. Like, I know a lot, like, you know, to be, like, customize it. So yeah. You feel me? Like, if I was to get it, I could, like, get one to customize it, and I could probably just resell it.
All right, let me ask you.
I probably wouldn't do that, to be honest with you.
You don't want to put no paint or nothing on the shoe because then the shoe's not going
to
be worth money.
Yeah, you don't want it to be flashy at all.
That's what I'm saying. Like, if I know someone that's pretty good at what they do, but I do get what you're saying, though.
Hey, what about the Tim Duncan Nike Air Foamposite Pro AARP pack?
Wait, say that one more time.
The Tim Duncan Nike Air Foamposite Pro AARP pack.
Oh, nah, we don't even got those either, man.
Have you seen those?
I've seen them, I've been looking at everything else, like, you know what I'm saying, like the Fluid Games and all these other 12s that are dropping.
Mm. I mean, what are your thoughts on that pack?
That pack?
Yeah, the AARP pack.
I mean, I think the pack is pretty nice. I mean, like, the quality is pretty good, and the shoes look pretty decent to me.
Oh, man, it's nice to actually talk to, like, sneakerheads that know their sneakers, and it took us to call San Antonio to, you know, finally find somebody who knows what they're talking about.
I mean, you know what I'm saying, when you've been in the game for about, like, 3 years, you kind of, like, pick up. So, like, my first shoe I actually, like, got, I camped out for that. He got game 13.
Oh, yeah. I can tell you really know your sneakers.
That's a banger, bro. Yeah. I just want to do it one time. Ginobili! I had to do it, bro.
Hey, you know what? If we get our hands on an AARP pack, we'll let you know. We'll call you back and let you know.
Hey, can we?
All right.
Hey, bro, before you hang up, can we use this audio? Because we actually have a radio show. So can we use this audio from the show?
Hold on, because I'm going to ask my manager real quick. Hold on. Wait, hey, I'm going to be on the radio? That'd be dope.
Yeah, you're going to be on the radio. All you got to do is just say yes. It ain't going to be nothing like incriminating or anything.
Yeah,
like
no, we didn't ask you for your social security number.
Yeah.
I mean, what radio station is it going to be on?
It's more of a podcast. It's on SneakerBartDetroit.com.
Damn, I got to write that down. I can't over really hear it. That's going to be dope, though.
Yeah, it's crazy. I want everybody to know that you are well-versed on your sneakers.
What's the name of it?
SneakerBox Podcast.
On SneakerBarDetroit.com. Yeah, I really have to say, you're one of the most knowledgeable sneakerheads we've ever talked to on the phone.
I mean, sometimes you got to know. A lot of people don't know what they're talking about. So half of the time when I do, hold on, bro. None of these pins are working. I'm trying to write it down so I can probably look into it later on.
All right, bet it up.
All right,
you got a pen to work yet, bro?
Yeah, I'm still. Yeah, all right, I got it. What's up? No.
All right,
say it one more time.
It's Sneaker Box Podcast.
Sneaker Box.
Cast.
All right.
And then you can look for it on SneakerBarDetroit.com.
Okay.
So it's cool to use it, right?
Hold on. Yeah. Hold on.
Yeah. He said, I heard yeah.
Yeah, I heard yeah too. I'm rolling with that one. I love how he ended that with, yeah, you know, it's nice, you know, I know my stuff. And
when you've been in it for 3 years.
Yeah,
I
you got to know what you're talking about.
All 3 years.
I just got him to admit he saw a pair of shoes that don't even exist.
Listen, I think I'm taking this segment from Caesar.
I might.
I think I'm personally better than this.
Hey, but I pulled that caveat at the end, though.
Man. He was like,
I know. I ain't want to brag, but yeah, I know my shoes.
You know how hard it is for me to stay away from this microphone while y'all do
that? I had to get up because
I just want to say, like, bro, it is not real.
I know, it doesn't exist. I know my shoes. I ain't been in the game for like 10 years.
Yeah, I saw that.
I know this other student that got him for sure.
I don't want to toot my own horn, but I'm quite the sneakerhead down here.
Oh, man. Let's
I'm quite the
these.
Collector.
Let's get to these releases.
Oh, man. My God. What was his name again?
Man,
he will forever live in infamy. Release dates brought to you by SneakerBarDetroit.com, the number one source of sneaker news and release dates. Hopefully he goes to the website and learns what shoes do and do not exist. Thursday, May 19th, you have the Nike Kyrie 2 Cavs. Friday, May 20th, you have the Fragment Design Special Edition Nike Lab HyperRev 2016 Collection. That is an overseas release only.
Because Europe matters.
Saturday, May 21st, Air Jordan Retro 2 Low OG Chicago, Air Jordan Retro 6 GS Cool Gray, the Air Jordan Retro 12 GS University Blue, the Air Jordan Retro 4 Premium Snakeskin, the Air Jordan 30 Gym Red, the Nike Kobe 11
Carpe Diem.
There you go. Adidas Samoa Pigskin Pack, Slam Jam Special Edition A6 Gel Light 3. That is also a European release only. Man, Saturday, May 21st is just loaded. Air Jordan Retro 1 Low No Swoosh Collection.
That must be the Kawhi Leonard.
The laces are like fuzzy, just like his braids. Adidas NMD Camo Pack.
He do gotta fix them edges.
Yeah, Juice. He got them Whoopi Goldberg color purple braids.
You sure?
You told Harpo to beat me. Juice Special Edition. Adidas Consortium Stan Smith. Ronnie Fake Special Edition. ASICS Gel Light 3 Super Green. Get those.
Yeah.
Ronnie Fake Special Edition. ASICS Gel Light 3.1 Super Green. And there is this huge Air Jordan restock at BBB Branded of Windsor. You can follow them on Instagram at BB Branded. Tuesday, May 24th, you have the Nike Air Griffey Max 1 Varsity Royal. Thursday, May 26th, you have the Nike KD 8 Elite Away.
It's pronounced Gordon.
I deserve that. Nike LeBron 13 Elite Black. Nike Kobe 11 Elite Low. Mark Parker. And the Rihanna Puma Creeper Collection.
I love creepers.
Do you? They're coming out in colorways. Let me see. This is three colorways. White Glow, Bordeaux.
It's pronounced Gordon.
Black Satin. Friday, May 27th, you have the Nike Kobe 11 Elite GS TV. Saturday, May 28th, you have the Air Jordan Retro 12 Flu Game. Get those. Under Armour Curry 2.5 colorways. They are exclusive to Under Armour and Foot Locker. Under Armour Curry 2 USA and the Adidas NMD Vintage White. Sunday, May 29th, the Air Jordan Retro 17 Plus Bulls Pass. Wednesday, June 1st, the Nike Air Zoom 90 IT White Black. Saturday, June 4th, you have the Air Jordan Retro 1 High OG Metallic Navy, the Air Jordan Retro 11 Low Varsity Red, Air Jordan Retro 11 Low Midnight Navy, the Air Jordan Retro 12 GS Hyperviolet, and the
I hope the guys don't get hyperviolet.
Nice. I like that.
I be doing it, bro.
I honestly, I'm glad I got you on the show.
Did he laugh? Go ahead, bro.
You have the Under Armour Curry 2 Gold Ring. Real quick, you getting those hyperviolets?
No.
No?
Okay. I don't like them.
She doesn't like girly colors like that, but she's a girly girl.
It's so weird.
It's weird, bro. It's like it's like doing coke, but saying you're not a drug addict.
Right.
Wow.
I don't like to eat, but man, I'm hungry. Tuesday, June 7th. Tuesday, June 7th, you have the Nike Kyrie 2 Karachi. Thursday, June 9th, the Neymar Special Edition Air Jordan Retro 5 Low.
Neymar been balling, bro.
Yeah. Friday, June 10th, Nike Flyknit Racer Turtle Orange. And then Saturday, June 11th, you have the Air Jordan Retro 9 Low Patone, the Nike LeBron 13 Command Force, the Air Jordan Retro 2 Low Midnight Navy, the Adidas Easy 750 Boost Grillik.
Two things real
quick. It's pronounced Gordon.
One, nobody is showing love to Neymar that he signed to Jordan. That is amazing for a soccer player to sign to Jordan.
Yep.
And then, two, I'm glad that there's a Pantone coming out that's not in the pack.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I agree. There's a bunch of shoes coming out,
brown
but that
Yeezy boots.
Nobody cares about. We'll get to those next week.
They're all overseas.
Yes. All right, so the Sneaker Box Lady Sneakers of the Week brought to you by Didi Negron and her Kick It With Didi 365
project. You so
stupid, Juan. On Instagram. Didi. My name is Sean. All right, White Ranger.
Oh, yeah. I got to tell you, I got very excited when I heard Kina tell me that she likes creepers.
Wow.
That was nice. High five, White Ranger.
I will be your creeper.
Oh, my God.
So this is the Sneakerbox Podcast, Lady Sneakerheads of the Week. Brought to you by Didi Negron, as Caesar said. Got to send a shout to Lulu Shug, Tondre.
We miss you, Ton.
Cure 1988. Can't forget OX Adriana. I think that's Hugs and Kisses. Mm-hmm. Adriana. Soul and Sunshine. Alexandra Blaze. She's definitely hot. In fact, you could say she's on fire. What the Courtney? I'll tell you what the Courtney. Come on over to White Ranger's place. Oh my. Gotta give a special send to Rocket Customs. Baby laces. No, I don't do no babies. Maybe close to underage, but no babies.
Somebody's getting arrested after the show.
I think they're waiting at the door. Kel, S-H-M-E, Amy. I don't know what that means, but man, it turns me on as long as she's of age. Have to send a special shout to my girl down in Dallas, our girl down in Dallas, Tanita.
Yes. A.K.A. Tata.
Yes.
Tata.
Shout out to Yolanda Adams.
Just do it.
And of course,
all of that. All right.
The show would not be complete if I didn't send, oh, special creeper love to Kina Monet. Welcome, girl.
All right. Why's your sunglasses on? But don't worry.
Wow.
Why are they all fogged up? That's what I want.
Ooh, whoa. Hi-yo.
So that is,
hi-yo.
That is the Sneakerbox Podcast, we Lady Sneakerheads of the Week.
No, we have not.
If you want to be part of the show, send a message on Instagram to Caesar, or you can follow me on Facebook at Barry White Ranger. That's it. I'm out. The police are knocking at the door.
Oh, my God. All right. Shout outs. Mike Rich, who's probably going to kill me when we go down to Atlanta.
Mr. Potty Mouth.
Yeah, that video is out of control, Mike Rich.
Oh,
get together.
Watch your language, Mr. Dirty Mouth.
Yes. Oh, follow him on Instagram at rich_mike23. Also, check out his YouTube channel. Not with your children, though. Rich.
He followed me on Instagram. Now I'm famous.
There you go. Yeah, you are official when Mike Rich follows you. That's how you know you made it in life.
Rich is actually cool, man.
He's super cool.
Rich is real cool, bro. He hasn't, like, you know, gone overboard with what he's become. You know what I'm
saying? He stayed the same.
Yeah.
Throughout it all. That's what I like about him. But check out his X-rated YouTube channel, Rich's Kid.
Do it.
Do it.
Do it.
Get your sub. Yeah, his videos are definitely not cleansed.
My most humble opinion.
Yeah, right. Sean Paper Jesse Williams and D Wells from OZ Live. Check out the past and present episodes on iTunes and Android podcast apps. And I think Sean just did a video with Network A again from the feed up. Check that out. I think it's on Network A's YouTube channel. Mo Sports Talk with Christopher Henderson, a.k.a. Hollywood Cole 85. Check out the website, mosportstalk.com. Check out Chris's YouTube channel by searching for Hollywood Cole 85 _. Juan Neal and the Loose Cannon Lifestyle Clothing Label. Go to shoplcls.com to check out the selection of t-shirts and apparel. You can follow him on Instagram at Loose Cannon Brand. If you live in the Metro Detroit area, you can go to a store that he has with longtime sneaker customizer, Illionaire, located at 195 West 9 Mile Road, Suite B2 in Ferndale, Michigan.
Maju.
Yes. And lastly, remember use Crep Protect, the official partners of the Sneaker Box Podcast, to clean and protect your shoes from anything life or nature throws at it. Get the most out of your sneakers. Practice safe stunting and go to crepprotect.com to get your shoes some protection. You can also follow them on Instagram and Twitter at Crep Protect.
I put that shit on everything.
Yes. I am the African Caesar. That is Juan Neal, Trufe, Kina Monet. This is episode 80, 20 away from 100. So,
dang, we at 80, bro.
Man, we are getting old.
It's so far, but not far enough. Let's get to 1,000.
I think yes. You might need an AARP card when you hit 80.
Yes, I think we do need an AARP card.
All this gray
card.
Hair in my beard, bro. I need a casket.
But we are a different animal and the same beast.
Yes. Hey, can we announce?
And you cannot, no, I ain't gonna say it. No.
Okay. No?
No. Yeah,
okay. All right, so that wraps up this show.
Now you got one more time, bro.
That's why I didn't say it.
Bye, people.
We'll see y'all next week. See ya. Peace. One.
Yeah, Caesar.
What's wrong?
My shoes are dirty, and I have a date tonight. If she sees my dirty shoes, she'll call me a poo-poo and slam the door in my face.
One. One. One.
Caesar, why'd you slap me?
Bro, all you have to do is use the Crepe cleaning kit and Crepe rain and stain resistant barrier spray, and you'll be all set for your date tonight.
Wow, Caesar. My shoes look amazing. And that jelly from that donut you spilled on my shoes rolled right off. Now I'm ready for my date, and I might even get laid.
Ha! I'm sure you won't get laid tonight, but you'll look good walking home alone, and your shoes will look great. Practice safe stunting. Go to CrepeProtect.com and get your shoes some protection. We all know why I'm going to need it tonight.
Hurt.